like the lotus growing out of the mud. My most fruitful changes came out of extreme inhibition and physical emotional abuse. And in the midst of that pain, I truly prayed, asked for help. And this extraordinarily beautiful humming voice came through my heart. And it just took me by such surprise. But every time I listened and began in my own way to reflect this tone, I instantly started to feel better. I called this voice Hama, my inner comforter, a companion, the mother of the world, that was always there for me when I asked. And gradually I began to walk all over the neighborhood. I could go anywhere and everywhere, and I could do it so quietly that nobody was the wiser. And every time I did, I came away feeling again so extraordinarily healthy, wholesome, alive, vital. And now at 81, humming, this simple tool of humming, has literally been life-changing and definitely a secret of my ageless vitality. There's so much research now, there's no time to go into it, except of course the endorphins, the oxytocin, serotonin, I mean all of these chemicals that are good feeling chemicals and stress busters and pain releasers. That's really one of the big things about it. So I know there's sound healing out there that uses humming. Oftentimes it's so straight, you know, it's kind of mechanical, quite honestly. And so I'd like you, from a book that I'm in the process of writing, The Hum of Love, The Feminine Voice of God. And the basics of that is that all energy's waves. And we've had to be quite straight in our posturing, so that the more we can bring more fluidity, almost if you could imagine your spine as seaweed floating through the water, you can see already that there is simply more grace, more enlivening energy that can move through the spine. Also, you'll notice that my hands are reflecting right now, of course, my speaking voice. But if I begin to hum through my spine, it's something like this, with this curving, rounding spine. Instantly, my whole body starts to shimmer and shake and wiggle, and it's saying, "Ooh, this feels good," and a joy, a sense of joyousness, starts streaming through me. So another piece of it is that you don't have to make your mouth, you know, so tight. You could actually feel an inner smile coming through you into the hum. And you can begin to imagine or sense vowelings. It's like a just as if it's more of a conversational language. As if this beautiful voice is speaking to you affirmations of such caringness, of such lovingness, of such wholesome aliveness. Oh, how incredible is that? You're never alone. And I hope that is true, that this is a gift that you can begin to play with. And it is the hum of love. And it is a simple, subtle opening And right now, just to close, many of us have had hurt hearts, broken hearts. So it's easier said than done. Open your heart, right? And so this, I call it, it's like an accordion, little musical instrument here that, come on, see the hum on, my inner comforter. Come on, you can do this. Is it safe? Opening up peripheral vision, taking a look, so you can always go back. And then, oh yes, it's safe. I can come out a little more. Goodness. And sometimes, you know, the pain is so great and we have so little places, you know, to exercise strong feelings in this world. So, a subject where there is pain, hama goes right in there, can moan and groan and send in these endorphin-like chemicals to break up the density and give you some fortitude and strength and power. Yes! So many blessings and praises to your hama, or hummer, I should say.